These people who are into Bhagavad Gita, Adhyatma, the spiritual stuff, simply don't know how to enjoy life. But we know how to enjoy. What to eat, what to drink, where to party, where to dance, music, everything. We know. These people simply keep talking about some hi-fi stuff, Bhagavad Gita and all that. They don't know how to enjoy life. These monks do not know how to enjoy life. Has this thought crossed your mind at any point? If so, my friends, do keep watching. We will see what is the real form of enjoyment that is there. But first, as always, it is story time. So let me take you back a few centuries back into the court of King Ashoka. Ashoka has just ascended the throne after a bloody family feud. He has killed many of his brothers and he has ascended the throne. And next to him is sitting his youngest brother, Tissa, on whom he has some special affection. He does not kill Tissa for some reason. And they are having a grand time. They are musicians, dancers, all kinds of jugglers doing all kinds of tricks. They are having a great gala party. At that time, two monks come into the court. Ashoka immediately stops all the gaiety party going on and he says, okay, let's hear to the monks. His brother Tissa gets disturbed. He does not like this sudden interruption. He was having such a nice time and these monks came and now they are talking some deep stuff. Some Adhyatma they are talking. He does not like. So, blinded by pride, he arrogantly starts insulting them. Saying, hey, what you monks are? You are having some shaven head. What kind of clothes? See, I am wearing the finest jewel, silk, gold, all these ornaments. You are wearing nothing. What is the use? What did you have for food? Do you want to have some liquor? Try this. You don't have liquor also? What kind of people you are? You don't know how to enjoy. And he insults them. But anyway, the monks ignore him. Ashoka ignores him. And they have their business. And the monks go off. Later in the night, Tissa is having another mini party with his friends. One of his friends happens to be a person called Radha Gupta, who is King Ashoka's chief minister. So the Radha Gupta says, hey Tissa, you look so handsome. You have all the qualities of the king. You are strong, you are chivalrous, brave. I want to see you sitting on the throne. Just show us once how it will be to if you are sitting on the throne. Tissa is also intoxicated. He agrees to the proposal. He goes, sits on the throne and strikes a pose, regal pose. At that moment, Ashoka enters and he says, aha, Tissa, so you also are like my other brothers. You had designs on occupying my throne. You have dared sit on my throne when you knew that only the king can sit on the throne. So, you are actually trying to rebel against me and for this, I'll have you executed. But since you are my brother, 7 days you can enjoy. At the end of the 7th day, your head will be cut off. And for 7 days, Tissa is given the finest jewels, the best silk, best food, wine, dancing girls, music, everything. They keep performing in front of him. The end of the 7th day, Ashoka comes in and says, okay Tissa, time's up. Time to die. I hope you had a good time all these 7 days. Tissa says, what are you talking of the good time? It was like the sword hanging on my head. Not even one moment could I enjoy all this. All the while I was thinking of this death. And I could not enjoy anything. That moment, Ashoka smiles and says, "So, Tissa, now you probably realize how, when you know that death is coming, you will not have any feeling of enjoyment. You will not have any desire for enjoying false things, temporary things. Those monks whom you insulted some days back in the court, they have realized, they have understood that death is going to come once, one day. And that is why they are not too thrilled by all these pleasures which you are valuing so much. You are blind to the fact that death will come. They are awake to the fact that death will come. Because you are blind, you are giving so much importance to all these joys. Because they are awake, they are looking for something permanent, something beyond this body, something at the level of the soul." So, my friends, Krishna is telling in the Bhagavad Gita 10th chapter, "Mrityu sarva harascha ham." I am the all-devouring death. At the time of death, everything goes off. This is not to psych you, my friends. This is not to scare you, saying, "Oh, you will die, you will die." Everyone has to die one day. This is not to actually make you into some kind of paranoids, thinking, "Oh, death is going to come, I have to be scared. Or death is going to come, let me keep enjoying. Who knows, zindagi milegi na dobaraga." No, not like that. It is to say that, okay, anyway, everyone has to die. When it will be, we do not know. It could be tomorrow or it could be 40 years from now. But it is going to come. So as smart people, we have to think of those things which will stay with us beyond death. And we have to invest time in that. That is the idea of the soul. In Mahabharata, a question is asked to King Yudhishthira by the Yaksha. He asks, "O King, what is the most surprising thing in the world?" And Yudhishthira says, "Every day people are seeing others die, but yet people are living their lives as if they will never die." My friends, the idea here is not to give up everything, give up your family, wife, boyfriend, husband, not to give up. Idea is not to give up your wealth, idea is not to give up your house. Bhagavad Gita says, how being in this world, yet you can develop that spirituality aspect in you. That is the beauty of Bhagavad Gita, my friends. You don't have to give up anything. Just add Krishna and his message of Bhagavad Gita in your life. And your life will become sublime. And you will look at some of the most important things that should matter. Something that will stay with you life after life. It will stay after death. It is your most permanent investment on yourself, on your real being, on your soul. So do consider actually taking a Bhagavad Gita. You can buy gift or sponsor. The money that we collect from this will go for the printing and publishing of books. The goal is to preserve Bhagavad Gita, not by locking it up, but by widely circulating it. So come, do join in this mission. Hare Krishna.